Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we shall learn all about the single responsibility principle and why is it important when writing some code or writing some piece of software. The single responsibility principle states that every software component should have one and only one responsibility. Let's read it once again. Every software component should have one and only one responsibility. There is one more definition of single responsibility principle. Let us see that one too. The second definition states that each and every software module should have one and only one reason to change. Let's read it again. Each and every software module should have one and only one reason to change. Let us quickly dive into writing some code or some software where we will actually be using the single responsibility principle. This will help us understand the earlier two definitions a bit more clearly. Let us suppose that we want to build a text editor. So the basic functions of a text editor could be that we should be able to set font size of the text we write, or we should be able to give some underlining to the text. We should be able to make the text bolder. We should be able to make the text italic, right? So and similarly we could have other functions too, right? And at the moment this code is written in JavaScript. If you are familiar with some other programming language, the concepts will still remain the same. So now let us examine if our class text editor actually follows the single responsibility principle or not. So as we can see that at the moment we have these four functions that we are currently using in the text editor, and the major function is to manipulate text or to change the format of the text we are writing into the editor. But over here we have one more function. This function basically what it does is it prints the text whatever we write in the editor to an A4 sheet. So basically this function what this does is it works as a printer to whatever we write in the text editor. Right, so if we look more clearly, we could see that there are majorly two types of functions. One where we are manipulating the text, and the other type is where we are printing the text, right? But what the principle of single responsibility states is that each and every software module should have only one and one responsibility, right? Or in other words, we can also say that each and every software module should have only a single reason to change. It should have only one reason to change. But if we examine in this class the number of reasons it has to change, so it has currently two reasons to change. The first one is that if we want to add a new feature or a new format or manipulation method that we want to implement, like suppose we want to add some color to the text, so we could also write the implementation of a new method. So one reason why this text editor class might change. But if suppose we change the size of the printing sheet to let us suppose a poster, or like suppose A3 or A5, there are more types of sheets that come, or suppose the printer configurations change, then also this function will change. So basically what the situation here is that we have two major reasons for this class to change. So what case there is that this class does not follow the principle of single responsibility. So to make this class follow the principle of single responsibility, what we need to do is we need to take this function out of this text editor class. So what we can do is we can create a new class named text printer, and what we can do is we can bring this what we can do is we can bring this function into this class. We take it out from here and we put it here, and what we can do over inside text editor class could be that we replace it with a very generic function named as, suppose that we name it as print text, right? And what we can do is we can create a new object of the text printer class. So suppose that we have now created the object for the printer class, and now what we can do is we can simply just use this method to print the object, and what we have to we'll have to do is we have to pass our text variable to this constructor, right? So as you can see, now we have two major functions, classes. One is text editor and the other is text printer. And what we can see is now both these classes have a single reason to change. Each one of them now has a single reason to change. If suppose that there are any configuration changes in the printer, so this function and therefore this class will change. And similarly, now any changes that might come to a printer or the printing format, it will only bring changes to this class. It will not this function still remains the same in each and every case or configuration, and hence the text editor class now does not depend on the text printer, right? So now hence therefore this all both of these classes now follow the principle of single responsibility. This program has been written in JavaScript, but if you are familiar with some other programming language, the concepts still remain the same. Let us examine one more example and try to find out if it actually follows the principle of single responsibility or not. So in this example, we have a class called users. The major functions that this class performs is to perform the CRUD operations, the create, read, update, and delete functions on user data. So if we clearly just take a look at this example, so we have a set of functions which perform operations on user data. But apart from that, we have one more function over here called as database connection. So in this users class, if we look very carefully, this class has two reasons to change. One would be if we have to add some new functionality to this users class, such let us suppose that we also want to delete user data from the database, so we can implement a function similar to that, right? And the other reason to change is let us suppose that we are using MySQL database currently in the application. So let us suppose that in the future we change our mind and now we want to use MongoDB as our database for the application. So in that case, the database connection method will also change. So it is very clear that the users class does not follow the principle of single responsibility, as it has two reasons to change. So now what we can do is we can create one more class called database connections, or let us suppose we call it DB connections. And what we can do is that we can implement all the functions we can implement all the functions where we have separate connections with separate databases. Like suppose that we have MySQL connection, so we can have a function for MySQL database connection, and on the other hand, similarly, we can have for MongoDB implementation too, like this. And now we have two functions. So and what happens here is that we will remove these functions, and what we can do is we will remove the implementation here, and we can create a new class called DB, and or we can use any of the methods as per our requirement. Like let us suppose we want to use MySQL database for our application, so what we will do is we will use this method. On the other hand, if suppose that we want let us suppose that we want to use MongoDB for this application, so what we will do is we will simply just use this method for MongoDB connection, right? And on the other hand, let us suppose that on the other hand, if we want to use MySQL as a database to the application, we can use this. So as you can see that only this, so you know the implementation still won't change. All the implementations for whatever connections we make, they all change here. We just shift the database, and whatever major changes that will occur in our users class will still belong to user functionality. One more thing that we have to keep in mind is that we have to take everything hand in hand. Like we should not break our class too much that it increases the complexity of the application. Like suppose we start breaking these classes, and we end up with like lots and lots of classes that we are only not able to manage. So we have to take care of that also. So like if we have some valid reason like for a class to break such that it follows a single responsibility principle, we should definitely break it, and this will, as we have already seen, that it lowers down the complexity. So as we can see in this example now that our users class now majorly changes will only occur when there is some other functionality that we want to add to the user data for manipulating the user data. Otherwise, for databases, there is for implementation all is taken care by our DB connections class. So all the implementations for all the databases occur inside these functions. So whenever these change, like suppose if you want to change the database name also, that also is taken care by the DB connections class. And this brings no change to our users class. So hence these two classes, again, they follow the principle of single responsibility.